S.P.Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walton Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss on site selection of a residential building. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to impart the knowledge and apply the principles of planning and design of the residential and the public buildings. Site selection. These are the factors which should be considered in the site selection. First is the purpose of the building. Second, the friendly neighborhood, available facilities, government laws, the shape and the size, the terrain condition, the type of the ground soil. Next is the natural light and the air. So the purpose of the building. The site selection, it plays an important role in the planning and the designing of the building. So the site should be selected in such a way that we should keep some view that whether for what purpose actually the building is to be constructed. So on that basis, the site is to be selected. Next, the site should be selected in a locality where the surrounding is already developed or it is likely to be developed. Also, the available facilities, such as the site should have nature gifts such as the sunlight, the airflow for the ventilation should be available. The government laws, the site which comes within the limits of the area where the bylaws of the locality authorized enforce the restrictions regarding the proportions of the plots to be built, the vacant spaces which are to be left to the sides and the front are to be considered. Even the building height should be considered. The shape and the size of the building, it plays an important role in the site selection. The terrain condition, the type of the ground soil, the strata selected over there should be of a uniform slope. It should be leveled, elevated, so we can provide a good and a quick drainage for the rainwater. The site should have the adverse circumstances, such as it should be free from the noise pollution, the air pollution. In short, the site should be selected away from the industrial area. It should also be away from the river carrying the flood so that we can avoid the waterlogging which may cause the settlement. And the friendly neighborhood. Actually, where the plot is to be selected, there the neighborhood should be of a friendly environment, that is it should match with our status so that the living conditions of our will be improved. The plot should have the various facilities, like the first is the community services, which includes overall the police stations, the fire protection services, the cleaning purpose, which are to be taken care of the wastages, and the street cleaning has to be done, and the utility services, which includes our daily utilities, that is the water supply, the gas, electricity and the telephones, etc. Amenities includes the schools, colleges, hospitals, etc. The shopping facilities is also an important factor in that, and the means of the transport should be available for the communication of easy and the quick transport. Here you can pause the video for 2 minutes and try to give the answer for this. What are the factors of the site selection? This is the answer for that. The shape of the plot. Second is the location of the plot. Availability of the amenities. Water table. And the sewerage system. First is the shape of the plot. So geometry of the plot, most probably for any kind of construction, the shape of the plot is very important. So that whenever we have to expand it in the future, we can easily come up with that. So that the shape of the plot is the most important, as it will affect the appearance of your structure. Location of the plot, main location should be nearby the main roads, and even the cost of the plot is a most important factor which will affect the cost. Availability of the amenities, also the provisions of the schools, colleges, the gas, electricities, etc. should be available nearby the plot. So the water table for the residential building should not be at a high level. Most probably the water table should be provided normal, which will be useful for the domestic and the drinking purposes. The water table at a normal height will be most preferable. The sewerage system, there should be proper sewerage system at the site of the residential plots. Extra water of houses can be easily drawn out, especially in the rains and the floods. If in case there is no sewerage system, the dirty water affects the building as well as the occupants as well. This is the site plan. Site plan is included to locate the area belonging to any building, showing all the details of the interior together with the surrounding. So here is one of the site plan drawing. Here you can see the kitchen cum dining hall. The room dimensions are given in the feet. This is the living room. This is the bedroom. So here you can see that this side there is a kitchen showing the interior details of the kitchen and the dining. Here is the WC and this is the bedroom. So the door and the window sizes are given to you. So the site plan indicates the overall the room dimensions and what is the plot size of your building, and at what distances the road margins are, and the setback lines, what are the front side margin left and the back side margin left of your building. So the site plan makes clear idea of even the drainage lines, the electricity lines. So this is the layout. This is the layout of the site plan drawing. These are the references which I have referred. Thank you.